everyone. It's Deidre again, and I have another great tip for you. As a matter of fact, I think this might be one of the best tips you find on my channel. This tip is about painting clean paint lines. And if you've ever tried to do a stripe, or let's say you're painting in a room and it has white trim, but you want a nice contrasting wall color, say brown or burgundy or purple and green, I've done all of those colors, and you want that nice clean paint line, but you really struggle. And I have struggled with that. And if you look online, you'll see a lot of videos where painters will show you how to prime their paintbrush with just the right amount of paint, and then they go to paint and they can have that nice, beautiful line. Well, in searching the videos, I have a tip that I've not seen anyone really hit on. And it's a tip that I've known for years, and that's why I say this is one of the best tips on my channel. Because I can teach you how to do that nice clean paint line, and you don't have to be a pro, and honestly, you don't have to use frog tape. And another painter's secret that I have found, if you do this search, is using a caulk gun and caulk. And that kind of starts leaning towards what I'm going to show you, but who wants to get out a caulk gun and caulk? I certainly don't. So what I'm going to show you uses everything that you're already going to have out, your paint, basically, and what I do use and do recommend and have always used is that plain, low adhesive blue painter's tape, not the frog tape, and we'll get into that a little bit later about what that technology is trying to achieve for you and why you don't need it and why actually it's not as successful as what I'm going to show you. So hold on, and I'm going to paint a wall today. Now it's not a high contrasting color, but you're still going to be able to see just how easy this is. And if you want more information on how I learned this trick and how I actually did this wall with these stripes, I'm going to do a second video following up very specific to that. So I hope you learned something today, and again, if you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comments section and I'll really try and get right back to you. Thanks again. Okay, like I was saying, there are a couple things on the market to help you get clean, precise paint lines. One is frog tape. Now, this is not frog tape. This is the general low adhesion blue painter's tape. And to get clean, precise lines, this is all you need. Now, you do want to use this versus masking tape. Masking tape, when you go to tape off your trim, has a tendency to potentially stick too much. So you could potentially pull off a couple paint layers. So you do want this tape. Now, the reason you don't need the frog tape is because we are going to seal the edge of this in a much easier way, in a much more successful way than with the frog tape. Some of the things that I've been reading about the frog tape and some of the difficulties with the frog tape, one, you're going to pay a lot more for it. But also, what they've done is, what I believe they call it is a gel polymer on the underside, and that gel polymer is activated when you put the latex paint on this side of it. And what that does is then it creates a barrier on this side of the tape that prevents anything from then seeping past it. In essence, that's what we are going to be doing, but we are going to do it in a much easier way and without any extra materials, just exactly what you already have, your existing paint and this tape. And my understanding is with the frog tape, a couple of difficulties happen. One, I've read both it sticks too much, and you run into the problem that you may have with regular masking tape is that when you go to pull it off, you can pull off too much. Sometimes I've read you even pull off the sheetrock paper. And also, some people say that if you have any dirt on your trim work, especially the top of windowsills, let's say, and that frog tape cannot adhere, then you're still going to get that bleed through. So we're going to take care of all of that. This is really a foolproof method of getting clean paint edge lines with only the blue low adhesive painter's tape and materials you already have. Okay, this is how we're going to get our clean edge. Now, I painted all the trim for this room last night, and that's my process. I'll do all the trim the day before, And you do want to make sure that your trim is dry, because when you go to tape, even with the low adhesive tape, you don't want to be in a situation where you painted an hour ago and you tape it, and then you go through all this and you pull the tape off and you've pulled off some of that fresh paint. So I paint the trim the day before. Then the next day you can tape this off and you don't have to worry about pulling the paint off. So what we're going to do is we're going to get our clean line by making sure that when we paint this wall, if it potentially bleeds underneath this tape, that any bleeding that occurs just doesn't matter. And by doing that, we're going to do what's called priming. And priming it is, in the 15-20 minutes before you go to paint this wall, on all these edges, whether it be on your trim or an adjacent wall, if this is a contrasting wall, and I even do it on my ceilings because I'm not good at even painting up against the ceilings. I'm going to take this color, which was my trim that I did last night, and this quickly, go down this entire wall, okay? That quickly, and that is literally all it needs. And I actually would do that around all my trim if I've taped it off. And if it's a contrasting wall, the better method is to actually take something called a clear glaze. Now, clear glazes were more popular years ago when everybody was faux finishing with their paints and all these great effects. But you can still buy clear glaze. Mine's just not in its original container. But you'll see it's kind of got a little cloudy finish, but it dries completely clear. Now, what that allows you to do is, I do this, and I've done it a lot, is what's nice about it is if you are doing a contrasting wall, let's say, you don't have to get out your trim color to prime, and you don't have to get out the adjacent wall color to prime to make sure what's bleeding, you know, matches that wall. And you don't have to get out your ceiling white paint to make sure that whatever might bleed up there matches the ceiling white. You take this brush, it's the same thing. You take a little bit and that fast. You go around the entire thing. Everything is sealed. You're going to get that perfect line. And you've only had to get out one thing and put that away. And by the time that you get out your wall color and stir your paint and load up your roller, you can paint, and you'll be doing this, of course, with a brush, that when you get any, you can go right up on this. You can even paint over it. You don't even have to worry about being right up against it. I actually paint over it, and you will get no bleed through because the bleeding has already happened. And that's the whole concept behind it. You've already done the bleed through. It has happened with something that just doesn't matter because it matches this underlying color. Okay, so let's show you what we've finished with here. Now, even though this new wall color isn't very contrasting, it's a mocha, so I hope that you can see that it's different than the white. So you can see, you know, I had taped it, and I used the trim color on the inside edge of this tape before I started painting the wall, and what that allowed us to do was to seal it so that any bleeding that happened, any seepage that happened, that got on the trim was the color of the trim, and therefore you're going to not have any problems, you're not going to have any colors that you don't want there. So then when we pull the tape off, you can see that just as perfectly as you could possibly want, you're going to have that beautiful, beautiful edge. Now, if you're like me, and you're a little OCD, but you don't have, you know, artist qualities, and you don't have great paint techniques, this makes me very happy. This is what I like to see when I'm finished painting. And I don't have to go back with my trim paint. I don't have to touch up anything. And you can imagine if that was red or green or blue or brown, how nice that edge would look. Okay, so even though this new wall color isn't a high contrasting color to this one, I think you can still see the clean line that we were able to achieve. So to review again, what we did is I taped this wall, which was an existing paint color. I didn't have this paint color, so I taped it off, and to seal the edge, all I did was I took that clear glaze very quickly with a brush, went down the tape, and that allowed that inner edge to seal. so that any bleeding that was going to occur was going to be clear against this wall. So now I'm going to show you, when we peel off, and get in there really close and show you, we have just this beautiful, beautiful, clean line. And that's because we did what I call priming, and we were able to seal the inside edge of that tape with the clear glaze. And you can imagine if that was a dark green, or a red, or a brown, all of which I've done, then you really save yourself a lot of work. If you notice on the tape, I pulled it off. You know, I was even able to paint not neatly with that new wall color over that, and there was no bleeding. So that's it on my very helpful tip on painting clean paint lines. I hope you found that helpful, and I hope that it makes your painting projects a little easier. At the end of this, I've just included a couple pictures of some paint colors that I've done where this has been very handy. So until next time, take care.